Hey everyone, it's Sandra. How are you? No, really, how are you? You know, normally we ask that question and we don't really mean it. We ask it just as a courtesy. It's a greeting that really doesn't require a true response. But I truly want to ask you, how are you today? Now, you know, at the beginning of this year, when I was writing down my goals and what I was going to do this year, as many of you know, my big goal for this year was Women on Fire Summit. And I could never have imagined that we would be postponing Women on Fire Summit, but even more important than that, that as a world, we would be literally shut down. And so I wanted to just reflect with you for a moment. And I also just wanted this to be a reminder to you that the fact that we are where we are doesn't change our goals. I want that to be a reminder to you that those goals, those dreams that you had at the beginning of this year, they don't change. The only thing that changes is the when and the how. The goal itself is not going to change. In my case, Women on Fire Summit did not happen on April 5th. We had to postpone. But what I know for sure is that Women on Fire Summit will happen. And so I also wanted to use this as an opportunity to share some of the wisdom from the people who would have been our speakers on April 5th and the people who absolutely will be our speakers when we eventually can reschedule the date for Women on Fire Summit. Stefan, as you know, is all about love. One of the things that I've heard him say, and one of the things that I love that he says, is that love starts with you. You can't give what you don't already have. And I know as mothers, as wives, as sisters, as daughters, in this incredibly unbelievable time that we're in, we're called upon to do so much more. But I wanted to remind you that you have to love you, that you have to be taking time for you, that it is not a selfish act for you to indulge yourself in some self-care, whatever that means. I know that in the past we would have said self-care would have meant going to the spa or going for a massage, but what does self-care look like? What does self-love look like in these quarantine times? I want you to make sure that you are loving on yourself. One of my favorite books from Gabby Bernstein is The Universe Has Your Back. I love this book. This was actually my introduction to Gabby. And she says in chapter 6 that obstacles are detours in the right direction. Just pause on that for a second. Obstacles are detours in the right direction. She says, the universe may throw you a curveball. Sometimes divine lessons come in odd forms. And I wonder for you, what is the universe telling you? What is the universe redirecting you to in this time? What I know for sure is that you have to trust. And as Gabby says, clear direction may not always be presented to you immediately, but know you are on the right path. Even the most difficult obstacles can be divine intervention. And this is one of the things that I want you to use this time that we have, this time when we have no choice but to spend time at home, to spend time with ourselves, for you to really question, what is the world that you want to go back to when we eventually get back to whatever the new normal is going to be? What is that world that you want to go back to? And what is this opportunity that we're being given? Because I truly believe that everything that happens in your life is there to be a lesson, to help you learn, or to help you grow. What is this time helping you to learn, or how is it helping you to grow? What is it helping you to learn about yourself? Lisa Nichols talks about how your mess is your message. And she talks about how the bigger the setback, the bigger the comeback. And so I want you as well to think about, what are you going to remember about this time? How will you be your own hero in this time? Now look, I want to be clear. Being a hero doesn't mean that you need to start a new business, you need to be baking fresh cookies every day, you need to have cleaned your house from top to bottom. It doesn't. Sometimes being a hero is acknowledging that you need help. Sometimes being a hero is acknowledging that you need to just sit and be still. And so what is that? What is the mess that is going to be your message? What is that thing that 6 months from now, a year from now, 5 years from now, you will look back at this time and say, remember when? And, you know, as the amazing Lindy and Anna say, the Love Pod Co-Girls, they say that it's all about affirmations, that words have power. The words that you speak about yourself have power. You literally create your world. You literally create your life with the words that you speak. I am are two of the most powerful words that you can say. Because as you know, I believe that whatever you say after I am shapes your destiny. And so what are those affirmations that you're saying to yourself? What is it that you're saying about yourself at this time? And maybe this is an opportunity for you to really revisit, to really think about what is your I am? If I was to ask you, who are you? What would you tell me? This is a great time for you to think about that and to reflect on that. So I just wanted this to be a reminder. I wanted this to be a love letter to you to tell you that everything is going to be okay. That we just have to trust that everything is okay. That as Gabby would say, the universe has our back. And that eventually, someday soon, we will have Women on Fire Summit and we can all gather and be inspired and feel empowered and feel uplifted by the words of all of our speakers and all of our panelists. But until then, I want this to be a reminder to you that whatever your goals, whatever your dreams were when you came into this year, don't give up on them. Don't give up on them just yet. Because the how may change, the when may change, but the what doesn't change. Much love to you. Let's make it a great day.